Morning guys, it's 10:30 and I'm about to turn off my air conditioning for the last time today. Bit nervous. I'm going to get a 3 p.m. train with Maya and Tyre to Marrakech. It's likely to take around 7 hours and the temperature today is set to hit 42 degrees here, 44 degrees in Marrakech. A little bit nervous, not gonna lie. The train does apparently have air conditioning, so that's a good thing. It's just gonna be getting there and getting to the hotel at the other end. So Maya's got some work to do today, so I have to check out of my Airbnb at 11 a.m. and the train leaves at 3 p.m. so it's that time in between when I'm gonna be sitting in a cafe trying not to sweat too much. Trying to stay hydrated, which is a bit of a struggle, to be honest. And then we're just gonna sit on the train for 7 hours, get off at Marrakech, go to our hotel and flump. So yeah, I'm excited to be on the road again, nervous to see how I cope with the heat, but let's go. I headed off with Tyre to Cafe Clock, which is a cafe close to the Blue Gate. I settled down with a fig smoothie and a Moroccan version of shakshuka. Cafe Clock was the perfect place to hide from the heat, with Wi-Fi, cold drinks, and most importantly, fans. I then spent way too long taking pictures of the place, just because I thought it was pretty. They even have goldfish. Meanwhile, Tyre went next door to Anu Cooperative. This is a wool production cooperative founded by former Peace Corps volunteers and Ashoka Social Entrepreneurship Fellows. I've left a link below. They gather wool, dye it, and run Moroccan rug weaving workshops. It's the perfect way to pass the time whilst waiting for your train. Continued with that, I headed out into the sweltering heat of the Medina for one last look around, and to go and visit a madrasa that Maya had recommended, the Madrasa Bounania. A madrasa is an educational institute, and when the students aren't there, you can take a look around and admire the architecture. I still think pictures look more impressive sometimes. Ancient Wi-Fi of the Medina, dating back to medieval times. Even though the madrasa was just up the street from Cafe Clock,
I still managed to get lost on the way back. There's no hope for me. I eventually made it, and Taya had a bowl of Harari to keep her strength up. The carpet was progressing well. The shop has a range of beautiful products, which I perused whilst waiting for Maya to catch up with us. Then it was off to the station. To stay hydrated, we bought juice. I want you to remember this fact as we race to find our carriage. Because the moment I got on the train, I proceeded to throw my half-drunk juice all over my seat. Luckily, I had a thick plastic bag to sit on. But for the rest of this 7-hour journey in 40-degree heat, I was stewing in a puddle of increasingly rancid mango. And no, the air conditioning wasn't really working. I did go to find the bathroom to clean up, but I came away feeling dirtier than when I went in. Getting back to my seat involved not falling out of an open train door, followed by a string of very British apologies. Also, if anybody has any idea what this is beside the train line from Fez to Marrakech, I'd love to know. The train from Fez to Marrakech costs around $35 economy and $50 first class one way. We opted for second class, and the main difference we could work out was that economy has 8 people to a booth and first class has 6. It did advertise as air conditioned, but it was still pretty sweaty. On the whole, it was a fairly easy journey. Just make sure your phone and earphones are charged, load up your local SIM with airtime, and settle in for a YouTube or audiobook marathon. And yes, I'm still stewing in a puddle of mango juice. Made it. Welcome to Marrakech. We hopped in a taxi and headed to our hotel, Riad Bab Lakhmis. Honestly, I have never been so glad to see a shower in my life. Another wonderful feature of this Riyadh is that there was an ice-cool dipping pool in the entrance lobby. We're going to be making use of that. Despite the hour, we headed out to find food. Chicken baps from a local vendor. One thing we quickly noticed was the prevalence of motorbikes in the Medina. There are a few of them in Fez, but not many. In Marrakech, they're everywhere, often travelling at breakneck speed down extremely narrow, extremely crowded streets. I imagine there's a lot of serious accidents. We ensconced ourselves on the roof to eat our baps before bed.